me for that, that's fine. But at the end of my job in Congress, I want to be able to look in the mirror and say I did everything I could with this moment I had, and this is part of that.
On taxes, you voted in favor of the House Republican tax plan. Right after that passed, Quinnipiac poll shows only 29% of Americans supported. Only 29% of Americans supported. 64%, Congressman, thinks it helps the wealthy more than it helps the middle class and poor folks. You worried about that?
You're always worried about that, about the perception of it. But look, we are arguing against, we are in a battle, to an extent, a political battle, against, you know, the same talking points we've heard for a long time. The 1%, the wealthiest, the richest, whatever. I think when people actually see their tax liability come down, in my district in Illinois, 70% of people file the standard deduction. That's doubled, as well as doubling the child tax credit. We'll see what ends up in the final package. They're going to see more money in their pockets. And beyond that, to make our corporations, our businesses, who a lot of times people like to talk down, but they're the driver, the engine, the small business of putting people to work and driving up middle class wages, they're going to be competitive.
Here's a problem, Congressman. It's not just about talking points about the top 1%. I mean, this is analysis from the Nonpartisan Tax Policy Center on the Senate bill, which I will say does have some differences from the House bill, but they analyze the Senate bill, and they say 7% of taxpayers will see higher taxes right away, 2019. Half will pay more in 2027, and the top 0.1% gets a $182,000 tax cut by 2027. Those are the numbers. Those aren't talking points. Are you comfortable with all that? Could you vote for a version that does that?
Well, look, when you talk about the 2027 number, this is what I dislike about the Senate rules. They have this gimmicky thing where they have to have them expire in 2027. I don't understand that. I don't know if that's going to end up in the final version. I'm not sure. But that's where those numbers come from. Say everybody's taxes are going to go up in 2027. It's because they have to have that sunset at that time. I don't like the rules. I don't like those games. Trust me, I don't.
But it doesn't change.
But the reality is people are going to get to keep more of their money. And when I look at this and say, I want to bring the tax code into the 21st century, not from 1986 at a time when nobody even had a computer in their house, to now being competitive internationally again. That is, America can do big things. And I'll tell you, other countries look at this, and if we make our corporate tax code competitive again and our individual tax code competitive, they're going to be like, well, look, we have to, America's back, basically. And I don't think you're going to see any more jobs leave this country because we have a lower corporate tax rate.
Congressman, thank you for joining us.
Anytime.
We'll have you back.
See ya.
Appreciate
Thanks.
It. So let's go back to California. You have raging wildfires that are out of control this morning. We're going to take you there live ahead. You're seeing flames around the Getty Center right by the 405 freeway there. A live report ahead. All right, back to our breaking news this morning. You're looking at images out of California, live in images that are stunning. A fast-moving wildfire in the heart of Los Angeles this morning. What you're seeing is the flames burning right next to the 405 freeway and right next to the Getty Center in Brentwood. They have forced officials to close part of the freeway, as you can see there. Let's go straight to our Stephanie Elam. She's in Ventura County. This has spread remarkably fast and remarkably close to these structures and neighborhoods.
And this is all from a fire that started around 5 o'clock in the morning, Poppy. That's how quickly this fire has developed there along the 405, right around Brentwood and Bel Air. And it is threatening homes. It is dangerous. It is moving quickly. And it's also impacting much of the area, as it's a massive thoroughfare between that connects two parts of the Los Angeles area. And this is the problem with these Santa Ana winds that we see here. It'll change things on a dime. And that's what we're seeing. That's what we've been seeing here. The wind starting to pick up here again, where I am in Ventura, which is about a couple hours north, hour and a half north of where you're seeing that fire. This fire yesterday, it's burned some 50,000 acres so far, and it is still out of control. Mandatory evacuations are in place. And this is just one fire. There are several fires burning here in Southern California, taxing the system. And the problem is other fires keep sparking up, like that one that you're looking at there by the Getty Center. Poppy.
Stephanie, thank you for keeping an eye on it. We will bring everyone more as soon as we have it. We appreciate it. But ahead for us, they broke their silence, and now they've been named Time's Person of the Year. Thousands of women stood up, spoke out, and said Me Too. Their battle cry against decades of sexual harassment landed them as Time Magazine's Person of the Year, the magazine's cover memorializing the silence breakers. The runner-up? President Trump and a few others. Our senior media correspondent Brian Stelter is here. This is big.
It is. It's a year that started with a women's march and ends with this cover, with Silence Breakers. You know, it's been exactly 2 months since the New York Times landed that first Harvey Weinstein story. Only 2 months since that scandal erupted. And we've seen dozens of allegations against dozens of powerful men since. We now see new attention in Washington as well. And what I love about this cover, we put it on screen, you'll notice there's an arm that sticks out there in the corner of the cover. It's for the next woman who may come forward, someone who wants to remain anonymous now but may speak out next week. If 2017 was about the silence being broken, 2018 has to be about systemic change. And to that point, I just put up a story on CNN.com about Mark Halperin accusers and Charlie Rose accusers
coming together,
forming a support group, forming a coalition. They want to see change in television newsrooms. And we're seeing that in other power centers as well. So this was a pretty easy choice, I think, for Time Magazine, recognizing this Me Too movement today.
Sheryl Sandberg, Facebook COO, said in her Facebook post this week, it is the power, stupid. You know how they used to say it's the economy, stupid?
Exactly.
It is the power.
The power. Yeah.
All right, Brian Stelter, thank you very much.
Thanks.
Ahead for us, Donald Trump Jr., the president's son, on Capitol Hill as we speak, facing questions from the House Intelligence Committee. We're on it.